Hollywood Orchestra, everything came together with the studio, the expertise of the people involved, and the players we have in Los Angeles. We were able to capture a lot more detail. We had unlimited time. We had a fantastic team.
Hollywood Orchestra, start to finish, was about 5 years. We did it in sections. We did strings, brass, woodwind, and percussion. We thought, you know what? Other collections were coming out, and they'd done some things better. And we thought, maybe it's time to do an upgrade. And we decided, because this was now going to be really sort of like the flagship version of Hollywood Orchestra, that we would call it Opus. And then we set about really sitting down and designing what Opus was going to be.
We had different players from last time, and they just brought a different character to the orchestra. What was really important this time around was that all of these players played together all of the time, and that is extremely important. The talent pool was considerable, with Sean Murphy as the engineer. To have him come in here and lend his perspective was comforting. I mean, after listening to so many incredible soundtracks that he'd recorded.
Almost all of the Star Wars movies, Jurassic Park, Indiana Jones, the Hunger Games movies, Apollo 13, Saving Private Ryan, Titanic. I mean, it just goes on and on and on. It's ridiculous. So we identified the areas where we thought it was a little lacking, areas that we thought that we could do some things better. So the original library was reimagined, and then we added a substantial amount of new material as well. It wasn't replacing what was there, it was adding to what was there.
As far as the new material that we recorded, the key was not to replace what we'd already done, and also not to do something completely different. So we decided to just take it further and elevate it to another level. In the new 18 violins, we had a different approach in how we captured legato. We used both the bow change legato technique and the traditional connected legato technique. They have a different character. The vibrato is different. The attitude is different. There's some particularly beautiful, soft, and mysterious articulations. Everything is at a higher level than you've ever seen before. The new two trombones are less bombastic, but they really bring something magical to the orchestra. The attention to detail, the fact that we've captured so many lengths of notes, you'll be really excited when you hear these. The two trumpets in the new Opus edition are an improvement over what we had originally. The players are extraordinary, and they play together all the time, and they are playing all of the dynamics at the same volume and level and attitude at all times. And that's in a key with brass samples. We paid a lot of attention to the original woodwind library and how we could improve the playability and also the realism of what we'd originally recorded, which was very strong. And at that point, we realized that we really wanted to go in a different direction to add to the woodwinds. And the logical conclusion was to do ensembles, because we already are dealing with grand orchestra, and woodwind ensembles are a big part of that sound. So we decided to do bassoons, clarinets, and flutes in ensembles. All of the ensembles, all of the players play together on a regular basis and really know how to tune and sync together in a way that makes these instruments really unique. I've never heard ensemble woodwinds like this. Studio One was the original room that Frank Sinatra recorded a lot of string orchestras in, and then there were many, many brass recordings done here.
The studios had something close to 150 Grammy nominations since we reopened it. That just says everything about how well it works artistically, acoustically. You know, we have magnificent vintage gear in here that you just can't buy.
Many engineers said that they thought this was the best sounding brass room in the world.
Studio One is just the perfect balance between that large scoring stage and something that you would do chamber music in, for example.
So we thought, rather than having folders of patches to wade through, it would be much more useful and much more enjoyable to give the user moods where you could just instantly change the attitude of the sound. Classic is the default, and you can choose a soft mood. When you do that, the sound is transformed in a number of ways. It's more focused on the softer dynamics. And then there's the epic mood, which is geared towards adventure, faster music, higher dynamics.
More bombastic. you know, more epic, something suitable to one of these sort of movies that demand that kind of soundtrack. The Orchestrator was an idea that was developed by a German company called Sonoscore. So I went to them and said, work with us, let's develop this for Hollywood Orchestra. We have a huge installed user base. It's something that we've always really wanted to do. The top composers that have very tight timelines, having to output sometimes 20 minutes of music a week, we hope will find this a very time-saving tool. So the Orchestrator consists of a MIDI-like step editor to build your own rhythm and scores. You can create patterns. We also have more than 400 presets in different categories and moods. Playable, full orchestra articulations, full orchestra sound with up to 16 patches across all instrument sections. Real-time arrangements based on your MIDI input with our innovative scoring engine. The whole orchestra at your fingertips. You can literally play a lot of this stuff with one or two fingers. About 5 years ago, we started building what is now called Opus, the software to replace the Play software. We've worked together as sound designers with our software team, headed up by Wolfgang Kundris, one of the developers of Cubase, Studio One, Nuendo. Then we got lucky, another Wolfgang Snyder, who developed Contact, joined our team. So now we had the two Wolfgangs, and I mean, literally, these guys are responsible for software that millions of people are using every day. So I think we got incredibly lucky. And I believe that we've incorporated our wish list that's been developed over a number of years. The level of control that you have over the libraries now is unparalleled.
You know, there was so much talk over the years about custom key switching that people want to be able to create their own key switches. We've now given you a very clear and simple way to create your own key switch.
You know, everything was redesigned. We even went back and remade the interfaces for the older products so they would hold up. Another thing for our growing list of Composer Cloud subscribers, you can now go into the database and you can drill down and you can find the instrument that you need out of tens of thousands of instruments. And if you didn't already have the library downloaded to your computer, you can just download that instrument and it's going to pull that instrument down in real time from the cloud. And it's going to be literally ready to use in a matter of minutes. It used to take hours to do that before. Everything that we've thought about in the last 5 years is simplicity. How do we make these vast, complicated, detailed tools simple to use? And that's no easy feat.
We are just building upon the strong base that we have and expanding the horizons.
The people that use and love Hollywood Orchestra are going to be very excited by what we've done here. We've really taken something that was a great product and we've made it better. Not only better, but easier to use. We've added brand new software. We've added the Orchestrator. I mean, this thing has just gone up another level. I hope that our users really appreciate the work that we've put into this to make their life a lot easier.